फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल टेक यू थ्रू द चैप्टर कॉल्ड अल्कोहल्स, फिनॉल्स एंड ईथर्स. सो इन आवर प्रीवियस चैप्टर्स वी हैव लर्नड दैट इफ यू नो वी टेक अ हाइड्रोकार्बन, वी ऑल नो व्हाट अ हाइड्रोकार्बन इज, राइट? चेन ऑफ कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन एटम्स इज नोन एज अ हाइड्रोकार्बन. सो इफ आई रिप्लेस, लेट अस से, वन हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम दैट हाइड्रोकार्बन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई टेक प्रोपेन, I replace this hydrogen over here and replace it with a OH group. I get this, right? The same hydrocarbon, the H replaced with an OH group. So, this new compound that is formed is having altogether different properties and applications, and we call these compounds alcohols. So, alcohols are formed when an hydrogen atom in an aliphatic hydrocarbon is replaced by OH group. Alright, a new word has come up, that is aliphatic. I'll take it up in a while. Similarly, phenols are formed when a hydrogen atom in an aromatic hydrocarbon is replaced by an OH group. Okay. Now, what are aliphatic compounds? Compounds are nothing but the compound that we saw a while back, right? So, to go to the definition of an aliphatic compound, carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms, when joined together in either straight chains or branched chains, are known as aliphatic compounds. For example, here we see a straight chained aliphatic compound, propane. Right? Sometimes you will see the CH3, CH2, CH3 and one more ethyl group attached to it, right? Which we will call 2-ethyl propane. So those are branched compounds. But till the time these compounds are straight or branched, these are called aliphatic compounds. What are aromatic then? They are also called aromatics. These compounds contain a system of p orbitals, you know, which are connected in a ring shape. This is our own benzene, right? So here, each carbon is sp2 hybridized, and this is how these, on the orbitals of the atoms actually look like. And these p orbitals are connected to each other. This a bond is formed between these two p orbitals of carbon atoms, then here and there. So, aromatic compounds have a ring-like structure, right? So, back to alcohols. When a hydrogen atom of these aromatic compounds is replaced by an OH group, we call the new compounds phenols. And when the hydrogen atom of these aliphatic compounds is replaced by an OH group, we call the new compounds as alcohols, right? Aliphatic is to alcohols, aromatic is to phenols. Alright. A wooden cupboard over here. Why do I see that? The polish polish the wooden furniture contains ethanol as the main ingredient. So what we are trying to show over here is how and where alcohols are present in our day-to-day life. So the wooden polish contains alcohol. Alright. The sugar we eat, sucrose, right, is nothing but a couple of OH groups, right? The sugar we eat, the cotton that is used for fabrics, as well as the paper. So all of these items used in our day-to-day life are composed of alcohols, right? Now we know what are alcohols when we replace hydrogen atom of a hydrocarbon with an OH group, we get alcohols. If that hydrocarbon is an aliphatic compound, we get alcohols. If that hydrocarbon is an aromatic compound, we get phenols, right? and wooden polish, sugar, paper are some of the examples of alcohols in our day-to-day life. Now, being science students, we are in the habit of classifying everything so that we get to study them easier. So, we classify alcohols as well: aliphatic monohydric, aliphatic dihydric, aliphatic polyhydric, aromatic, and phenols. These are the five classification of alcohols, you know, which we are going to study from now. First and foremost, aliphatic monohydric alcohols. These alcohols are further classified into vinylic and benzylic, right? Okay, now we come to the vinylic alcohols. So, we studied that whenever the H group of a hydrocarbon, right, is replaced by an OH group, we get an alcohol. Now, that hydrocarbon can be an alkane and alkene, right? So, when that hydrocarbon is an alkene, or in other words, when this hydroxyl group is attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon, and when will the carbon be sp2 hybridized? When there is a carbon-carbon double bond, right? So, when this OH group is attached to a carbon-carbon double bond, we get vinylic alcohols, right? And what are allylic alcohols? They are again classified into primary, secondary, and tertiary.